What's going on, guys? This is Ryan with RK Outpost, and we have more bad news for Marvel and for Disney, as one of their big stars of their recently released movie is saying, "Pay me what I am owed." You can see from the headline, Scarlett Johansson sues Disney for breach of contract over Black Widow release. Now, this is blowing up right now. It's in all the news, different articles, people tagging me on Twitter. Everyone is talking about this, and some people seem to be in a state of shock that Scarlett Johansson would ever sue Disney over something like this. I'll be real, I'm not surprised or shocked by this news. You're going to see more of this coming, especially for these movies, whether it's from directors, whether it's from people involved in production, whether it's stars. You're going to see more lawsuits like this, as we have a lot of different places like Disney on Disney Plus, like we have Warner Brothers with HBO Max, that are not having the sort of release that they thought they would have with these movies when they made them. And you're going to see what Scarlett Johansson is saying, that hey, there were certain obligations in my contract that if it met this benchmark in the box office, they would have to pay me a certain amount of money. Well, when you don't release a movie just in the box office, but also make it available on your streaming service, sometimes at a premium price like Disney Plus, sometimes not like HBO Max, that changes so many things. That changes so many different contracts and whether people would have signed them or not. You are going to see a ton of things just like this happening in the near future, mark my words. But let's go through the article right now, see what everyone's talking about. Disney's decision to release Black Widow on Disney Plus at the same time it hit theaters has sparked a legal battle with Marvel movies star Scarlett Johansson. In a lawsuit filed Thursday in the LA Superior Court, attorneys for Johansson allege the actress's contract was breached when the studio opted not to debut the film exclusively in theaters, a move they claim depressed ticket sales for the Avengers spinoff. Much of Johansson's compensation was tied to the box office performance of Black Widow. If it hit certain benchmarks, bonuses would kick in. And here's the quote. Disney intentionally induced Marvel's breach of agreement without justification in order to prevent Miss Johansson from realizing the full benefit of her bargain with Marvel. Now, of course, you're going to have certain sides that have their different opinions on this. I don't think Disney's going to sit there and agree that, yes, we intentionally did this just so Scarlett Johansson would not get her money. But it is a result, whether it was intended or not. And depending on the language in this contract, it could definitively be a breach of contract that resulted in significant financial loss for Scarlett Johansson. The bigger story to me about this entire thing is this, the fact that Black Widow just did not do well. They can tell us, oh, look what it did opening weekend. Well, it fell off. It fell off harder than any MCU movie we have ever seen in history. You can try to blame it on Disney Plus. You can do all that you want. But the reality is, the movie itself made people not interested in seeing it. The fact that it was way too late, that it should have been done before you killed her off in Endgame. The fact that Marvel, Phase 4 of Marvel, is all about pushing identity politics. That is a big problem for a lot of people. This movie is not doing well, either domestically or internationally, regardless of how open different places are. And you can't tell me that the Disney Plus take was really that big of a deal. You told us what the first week was, then you were silent because it did so terribly on Disney Plus premium access. That is very obvious right now. Disney announced in March that Black Widow, among several of its 2021 films, would premiere simultaneously on the studio's subscription-based streaming service for a premium $30 price and on the big screen as movie theater industry rebounded from COVID. On July 9th, Black Widow opened to $80 million in the US and Canada, setting a COVID-era box office record and reportedly earned an additional $60 million on Disney+. With ticket sales currently sitting at $319 million globally, it stands to be one of the lowest grossing Marvel movies. And not only will it be low grossing, it will lose money. That's almost guaranteed at this point, because you have a movie that was $200 million to make. You have to figure that when you factor in advertising, which they had to advertise twice for this movie, maybe even three times, you're probably pushing a 325, maybe even 350. So it probably hasn't even made its money back when you're looking at that, let alone the box office cut. Now Scarlett Johansson is saying, you are responsible for this movie happening. You are responsible for not making as much as it could have with the release on Disney+. I want financial compensation. Disney chose to placate Wall Street investors and pad its bottom line rather than allow its subsidiary Marvel to comply with the agreement, because they're saying that Disney stock rose after the company said, hey, look at how good we did on Disney Plus. You are going to see so much more of this, whether we're talking about something upcoming, maybe Dune, right? We know that director of Dune did not want his movie to be released on HBO Max, but it certainly looks as though that will be the case. So many of these other things, they probably have agreements in place if they meet certain box office requirements that releasing it on a streaming service, it does impact it. Now, is it going to impact the fact to make this movie a flop like Black Widow? Probably not, but there's no doubt that there is an impact and that you will continue to see things like this happening. To no one's surprise, Disney breach of the agreement successfully pulled millions of fans away from the theaters and towards its Disney Plus streaming services. And this is one of the things, when you go out there and brag about how much money you made on Disney Plus, well, then you do give them reason to be like, well, you said 60 million, that would be at least 2 million people paid for this on Disney Plus. What about those people? So now they have tangible numbers to make this argument with. The Wall Street Journal, which broke the news of the lawsuit, reports the sources close to Johansson estimated the decision to release the film currently on Disney Plus resulted in $50 million in lost bonuses. That is interesting. So they're saying $50 million in damages because of this. So if you hadn't done it, if it had all been in theaters, we would have made those benchmarks and everybody somehow would have got $50 million in bonuses. Kind of insane. Now, they do mention here, they go a little bit into Warner Brothers and how they have done it. It says, when Warner Brothers opted to send its entire film slate to HBO Max, realizing that movie theaters were only operating in limited capacity, the studio had to pay tens of millions of dollars to the stars of those films. That resulted in actors like Will Smith, Denzel Washington, Keanu Reeves earning their full back end on the movies Warner Brothers released on its new service. One thing that doesn't take into account, like I was mentioning earlier, are directors, are other people that are incentivized in some way to be a part of this that may get a cut of it in some way that aren't just the big top line actors. I do think you are going to continue to see more things like this, whether it's 6 months from now, whether it's tomorrow, whether it's quite some time of people going back and looking what happened and realizing that, yeah, Warner Brothers and Disney may have breached their contracts and they didn't offer enough compensation. They didn't do it the right way. A lot of things like that I do feel will be happening. And that's why this is not really that much of a shock or a surprise to me. I think we're going to see a lot more of it. But it's funny because, listen, Marvel, Disney and Marvel Phase 4, it's on a downward trend. More bad news as Scarlett Johansson, the one you were promoting that you wanted to put out there. Look at what we're doing, this strong, powerful woman. Well, she wants you to pay what she thinks that she's fucking owed, right? Now, she is suing Disney. She is saying that Marvel and Disney fucked her over when it comes to the flop that is Black Widow. Let me know your thoughts about all this in the comments below. Smash a like button, subscribe to the channel, ring the bell for notifications, share this video out there, and I'll talk to you later. Thanks for watching, everyone. And a huge shout out to my patrons, I appreciate you guys so much. Want to follow me on Twitter or Instagram? Check out the description below. You'll find links to my PO box and my Patreon as well. And I'll talk to you guys later.